Just Culture is all about fairness. It's about equity. It's about learning. That's really what Montefiore has always stood for. And we realized with our goal of being the most high reliable, safest health system in the country, Just Culture was an important component of getting us there. The key was adjusting the lens to focus on the true cause of errors, which is often the complex interplay between clinician and system. That new lens, which allowed us to focus more on the system side, was really the direction we needed to go in order to make our organization as safe as possible.
There's been an expectation that providers that work in hospitals are the top 1%, and they're perfect, they never make mistakes. And when a mistake happens, the right answer is, next time, work harder, concentrate harder. But that can't be the solution. We have to be allowed to make errors. We have to be allowed to forget to make a phone call or leave our keys at home. Everybody does it. At the heart of a Just Culture is a recognition that people are humans and that they can make errors. We need to create systems that will keep human errors from reaching the patient. We need to identify them and then fix them.
The Department of OBGYN and Women's Health was very interested in changing our QI process, and along with the leadership from Montefiore, we were introduced to this concept of Just Culture. We're really pleased and satisfied with it, and I guess for the medical staff, and most particularly for the patients, that we're able to look and focus at systems issues and be able to correct things to improve safety.
It changes the whole culture of how we're doing things to allow people to become part of the solution instead of fearing for their own careers, their own livelihood.
So I was the attending on call covering labor and delivery. I was taking care of a young, healthy woman who was in labor with her first baby. Going into the early hours of the morning, around 7 a.m., she was in a significant amount of pain and requested epidural anesthesia. She had the epidural placed without any complications. She and the baby were doing well. At about 7:30 in the morning, we typically go one floor up above labor and delivery to do a teaching conference with our residents. About halfway through the conference, the attending came into the room visibly upset and said, "Dr. Goffman, they're coding your patient in room 6. So immediately myself, along with the entire team around the table, ran out of the room. And upon arriving on labor and delivery, I went to the bedside, evaluated the patient. Interesting findings were that her blood pressure was normal, her heart rate was normal, the fetal heart rate tracing was normal. However, she was unresponsive to verbal stimuli, to painful stimuli, to touch, and she was not breathing. There were a number of us, a cardiologist, an intensivist, and myself at the bedside, very puzzled by what had happened to the patient. The anesthesia resident tapped me on the shoulder, and she told me that she had made a medication error. Rather than pulling out a vial of ephedrine, she had pulled out a vial of succinylcholine. Succinylcholine is a paralytic, so it actually helped make sense of all of the findings in the room. The patient was paralyzed. As the medication wore off, the patient became responsive. She had a normal vaginal delivery of a healthy newborn. She and the baby both did well and went home together. We needed to try to get to the bottom of which systems errors were involved in this patient's case. The anesthesia cart had a drawer. In the drawer was a bunch of medication, all sort of jumbled together, not clearly separated by any dividers, not clearly in labeled sections. And I think under pressure with a pregnant woman with a low blood pressure, the resident reached for what she knew she needed. So that's a very easy systems issue that was corrected. The anesthesia cart was reorganized. Things were separated. Things were clearly labeled.
And so when we look at an adverse event, we really want to discern, could a safer system been in place to allow a provider to make an error and still not let that error reach the patient?
We realized that Just Culture was a very important component of our transformation to a high reliable organization, but we couldn't find a simple way of operationalizing those concepts. The Just Culture tool provides a very easy to use, uniform way that really anybody can use. One can pick it up and orient themselves to the tool and understand its principles.
The Just Culture tool is very simple, easy to memorize, so that a manager, in real time, without going back to grab their tool or algorithm, they have it memorized, they ask themselves two very simple questions. Could somebody else have made the error, and was it intentional or not?
I've personally used the Just Culture tool. What we really appreciate about it in nursing is that a nurse manager, when approached by a staff nurse or any associate on a floor and reports an error that just happened, the nurse manager, without even having the tool on them, can ask some very simple questions, and it will help guide their initial response.
The change to a Just Culture really has motivated staff. It's created a new enthusiasm in peer review and looking at adverse events and near misses. People are more apt to come forward with cases that they traditionally would hide because they were afraid that they would be accused or looked at in a punitive manner. They now feel comfortable that they can come forward and that the system, the organization, is committed to the shared accountability that is not just looking at their practice, but looking at a way that we can fix things and make things better for both patients and our own staff.
A second victim is a healthcare provider who has made the mistake or the error and feels personally really anguished by it. Say, for example, a nurse who is involved in a medication error, now there potentially is harm to the patient, but that staff nurse is feeling, on a personal level, very sad and very concerned, and professionally doubting their skills and competence, and ultimately they're in the middle of an error that had other factors contributing to it, so they themselves actually are victims of a system that they're working within.
Nina's story demonstrates the power and versatility of the Just Culture tool. While preparing a pediatric TPN solution, Nina became the victim of a systems error that had potentially catastrophic consequences.
When she was working, the sterile water 2-liter bag ran out. And what she did, she took a bag that looked very similar to a sterile water and hung what we call Travisol 10%. Now, Travisol is a highly concentrated amino acid. And what Nina did was she went and took the old label off the old bag and placed it on the error bag of Travisol. Travisol is never used in the NICU or pediatric population. We use an alternative product that they use specifically for the NICU patients. If we did use this agent, the potential for harm to one of these pediatric patients would have been great.
The incorrect solution was already being delivered to multiple locations within the Montefiore Health System.
For a few seconds, I feel like I couldn't move. I was like in panic. And I went to my pharmacist right away. I told her that I made a mistake, a big mistake.
Nina saw that she hung the wrong bag, and she stopped immediately, and she felt comfortable enough to come forward to report the error to her supervisor. And we stopped everything, and we proceeded to retrieve all the bags. Well, the day after the event, I met with the director of operations, and prior to bringing Nina in, we asked ourselves two questions, and these questions are used on the Just Culture tool. Number one, did she intentionally violate the standard of care? And we both agreed that she did not. It was a systems error. Then we also asked ourselves the second question. If somebody else was in that clean room, could they have made the same exact error? And we both agreed, yes, anybody could have made the error. So we brought Nina in, consoled her, and we told her it was a human error. Well, Nina wasn't only visibly upset, she was emotionally upset. She explained to me that she couldn't sleep all night.
She was a true second victim.
And then we went to the office and we talked in private. He even cried with me because I was crying, and I say, don't worry, you know, everything is gonna be okay. We're not gonna punish you for this. We know that you are a very good technician. And thank God you did the right thing, that you grabbed this and you didn't isolate the problem. Because some people, they isolate the problem because they think that they're gonna be punished or something. But I didn't care. I didn't care what happened to me. I just care about what happened to the patients.
I was so happy that she came forward to report the error. She saved the lives of many patients that day.
By developing a just culture, we think we're creating the atmosphere where people will be willing and excited to tell them about errors, because they know when they do that we're not going to blame them, but more we're going to try to learn from them and make the environment in which they work and in which we care for our patients safer. Our teams have embraced the Just Cultural Tool because of its simplicity and its fairness, and it's really, over the last few years, transformed our culture.
Well, I certainly believe that Just Culture is helping to make things safer. It's allowed us to bring more people into the effort to develop systems where fewer things fall through the cracks, where fewer things get hidden, and people are more engaged in trying to do better for our patients.
So I think all departments, hospitals, divisions should move towards a just culture. I think it's the right thing to do. I think it's the way we're moving in medicine and safety.
If we can create a culture, a just culture, a learning culture, a culture of fairness here at Montefiore, we believe that our front lines will see that. They'll tell us when bad things happen. They'll tell us when bad things almost happen, so that we can learn from them and make sure that they don't happen again.
Just culture, to me, means that people have the freedom, the will, and the drive to contribute to making the culture better. And they do because when they are behaving in that fashion, when they're trying to solve problems, not stay hidden, they are rewarded. And what's the reward? They do better work, the outcomes are better, the patients do better, and the community feels good about what they do.